All right, TC is with us now. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
When you were cast in War Room, did you really think, I mean, really, that it was going to do so well at the box office?
Not number one. No. I remember we were at the premiere. We were all getting together, and we had done three premieres, and we were saying to ourselves, okay, just as a fan, what do y'all think War Room was going to do? And we were all throwing out numbers and stuff. And we all say, well, it'd be cool. When you look at the history of their films, they've done well, you know, top four, top five. But number one, just unbelievable that it did what it did.
You're quite a good actor because you're such a nice guy. But in the role you played in Tony, you did a very nice job being a very mean husband, didn't you?
Yeah, I mean, it's so funny because when I'm watching it in theaters with people, the first 40 minutes or so, it's just like you're just sinking down in your seat because the women in there is like, oh, I could just slap him in his head right now. You know, and I remember those moments where we knew we had to take the audience there because you want to take them on this emotional ride where later on they're cheering for you. And so it was challenging.
Why do you think the film resonated with so many people?
I think there's a lot of reasons. When I get asked, I think of a few things. Number one, you know, with Christians, you're talking about Jesus in prayer. Those are the pillars of our faith. These are things you should do every single day. And then this film is excelling, and the world is talking about Jesus in prayer. So that's one thing. The other thing, I think you can see yourself in a lot of the different characters in the film. Yeah. You know, I think men, you know, resonate, you know, with Tony and his journey. And then there's women resonating with, you know, Elizabeth's journey. Then you got people who are mentoring other people will resonate with Miss Clara, and you got the kids. And I think everybody can see themselves somewhere in there. And you see in these real life situations and how not everything always works out. I think that's a nice element to it. So I just think you can see yourself there. And again, we're trying to teach everybody how to pray their way out. And I think a lot of people will want to learn how to have a stronger prayer life.
Well, let's touch on something you mentioned, that not everything works out. Because if you had followed your own purpose, you've written a book about finding God's purpose for your life.
Yeah.
Your plan was to be in the NFL.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about that journey.
Yeah, starting at age 12, all I wanted to do was make it to the NFL. You know, I remember writing those goals down and chasing it with everything that I had. And because there's nothing inherently wrong with football, it's not sinful to want to play football, it's a good thing. But that didn't mean it was the thing that God wanted me to do. But yet, I chased it with everything I had. And I went to University of Louisville, played well there, and all the stars, as they like to say, seemed to line up to where I'm going to make it here. And so everything was just lining up for me. But in 2008, I had the best season that I had ever had, and I thought that would turn into NFL success. And then when it didn't, I was just exhausted. Yeah. Like, I literally just got tired of failing, and I didn't understand because it was so positive, and I had all these great plans. I was going to glorify the Lord, and all these things sound good.
Yeah, and why wouldn't he let you do that? If your plan's to glorify him, he should make the path straight, right?
Yeah, and that's what we think. But the Bible clearly tells us, and scripture after scripture tells us, that it's not my plans that are blessed and ordained, even if they involve Jesus or whatever. It's his plans that are blessed and ordained. And so I had to trade in my will for his will, and that's when everything changed.
You think sometimes we say, okay, God, here's the plan I'm going to pursue. Now, please bless it, as opposed to saying, what do you want for me, and give me the strength and faith to follow?
That's exactly what a lot of us do. I know I did. And you take something and you try to make it good, and it's almost like preposition God, like a proposition.
Mm-hmm.
You proposition God, like, okay, God, if you allow me to play football, I'm going to give all the money to the poor. I'm going to do this.
I'm doing this for you.
Yeah, this is for you, and it'll be such a good testimony, and this person will be, you know, we can point this person to you, and you do all this because you want to do it. And then it's funny, it's like, you know, God's like, okay, well, how about I want you to go and be persecuted in another country? That could glorify me too. You know, if it's all about my glory, you'll do whatever I want you to do, right? And that's when it's like, I don't know. And so I've learned to just, if you let the Holy Spirit lead out in purpose, it gives you the courage, it gives you the strength, it makes sense of what you're doing. Because in my own human nature, I'm gonna do what I'm comfortable with and what I wanna do. And I try to bring God along for the ride, as opposed to letting him lead.
And so God opened doors for you to become an actor, a series of things that you didn't see coming, that he opened the door. So tell us how people can find their purpose and plan. It's easier said than done.
I think, and this is so, this question being answered to me has just been a life-changing thing. And it's funny, because I don't think it's nothing revolutionary or radical or anything. I open up the Bible one day, I'm just reading, and I see in scripture, Psalms 139:16, where he says, I saw you before you were born. Every day of your life was recorded in my book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. I looked at that. Bible can't lie. God says, I made a life for you. Consult me about it. And I just literally did that, and it changed everything. That's how you find your purpose, by asking God, what did he make you to do? It's that simple. And then you, but again, you want to have faith that he will answer that. And when he does, that's the rough part. I didn't say it was easy. It's simple, but that doesn't mean it's easy. But once he answers that, then you got to pray for the strength and courage to pursue this road, because you don't know what it is, but that's what faith is all about.
Just have under a minute left. So tell us a key principle that God showed you on your exploration of his word.
Well, I list 14 of them, and there's a couple that I can highlight. You know, one of them is Matthew 7:21 is one where he says, not everyone who calls out to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only those who do the will of the Father. And when I look at Psalm 139:16, he says, this is what I made you to do. That means that's his will for my life. And if I don't do that, that means I could be doing a lot of cool things, but I'm not lining up with Jesus and doing them. I'm just doing whatever I want. That scripture is sobering. So that was one. Then the other one is James 4:13, where it says, your life is but a mist. Yep. You could be here today, gone tomorrow. And that creates a sense of urgency. I don't know what my tomorrow holds. I could be gone. And in my book, I talk about nearly dying in a car crash. And that woke me up. And if Jesus looked at me and said, you know, when I die, I need him to be able to say, you've been doing everything I called you to do. You're living out your purpose. And and that's the other principle, to help people get a sense of urgency. And don't wait, because you don't know what tomorrow holds.
So. It's a great reminder, and it's a great book. We thank you for being here. TC's book is called The Pursuit. It includes his personal story and also, as he said, 14 scriptures and chapters to help you discover God's purpose for your life. I encourage you to pick it up.